photography, analytical science for the pharmaceutical industry, and then I moved on into food analysis.
In the flavor team at the beginning, I was working mainly on Oreo, biscuit, cocoa liquor, chocolate, and then I went to the lipid team.
Calibration officer and archiving assistant.
I use a technique known as mass spectrometry to help clients solve problems so that their products are as safe as can be for patients.
I do lots of different work looking at unknown materials, so trying to work out what they are from their chemical and elemental composition.
So I'm Maddie and I work as a trainee scientist at RSSL. So as a trainee I get to move around different departments whilst I'm also studying for my HNC.
And I work in the pharmaceutical division looking at primarily at investigations, so looking at unknown species in drug products.
Currently work in the functional ingredients department as a senior scientist. However, I previously was working in the pharmaceutical department.
I did a degree in chemistry at Birmingham, so that was my stepping stone into. I don't think you necessarily need to do a degree, but I think it helps.
I have worked in science or technical backgrounds ever since I left college. I started working at Portsmouth Polytechnic in the geology department many, many, many years ago. And from there, spent nearly 30 years working in the oil industry.
So for my A-levels, I did maths, physics, chemistry, and biology. And then after that, I did an undergraduate degree in forensic science in South Wales. And then after that, I went to the University of Warwick to do a PhD in mass spectrometry, which is my specialism.
So I did a master's at the University of Southampton, and it had a year placement in, which was a really good opportunity to get that sort of experience.
As a trainee, I get to move around different departments whilst I'm also studying for my HNC. So that's 2 years, and then I can then look to obtain a permanent role to then study for a full bachelor's degree.
I like the variety. I like the getting a call with a customer and them asking you, you know, they have a problem and you're trying to solve that problem off the top of your head.
Being able to ask questions and that there is no silly question.
I quite enjoy trying to solve complex problems, and when I'm able to use the skills I've learned over, you know, many years, it's quite enjoyable when I can go to a client and say, this is what your problem was.
So I get to work on lots of different types of samples, so from glass fragments that are found in food to marks on pharmaceutical tablets.
I think it's just being able to be part of something that's bigger than just myself, and that I know that I'm playing a small part in what is a really important thing.
My favourite part of the job is probably looking at the investigations. It's genuinely good fun to get the MS data, look at it and try to interpret it and identify this unknown peak that the client has asked us to identify.
Being involved in something the way you're giving back, so whether that is more recently in my job where it's both food and pharmaceutical products, or in my previous role where it's pharmaceuticals, where you're doing testing that is genuinely really important to get that product out to the end user.
Seeing our teams deliver safe products to market, creating beautiful tasting sugar-free products, for example, helping with managing allergens in the marketplace, helping companies decide do they need to make a product recall or is it safe to go on the shelves.
I think the advice that I would give them is to really think about what role that might be. There's so many roles in science that people might not necessarily know about. So to do a bit of research, if they can get work experience, that would be amazing. I know it's difficult though.
I think the first thing I'd say to them is, if you're going to have a career in science, make sure it's in an area that you're passionate about, because this could be your career for many decades.
If you have one science and another subject, say English or maths or whatever, you can cover a lot of bases. You don't have to do science at degree level, but any science degree level you wish to do, they're going to want A level in a science.
Be scared. I think the role that you choose right at the beginning doesn't have to be forever. You are allowed to chop and change and try new things and there's no real time limit on that. So don't be scared to take a leap and try something and then see what happens.